To use the Blend tool, select the Shape tool and draw a shape that has a fill but no stroke. Then, draw another shape of your choice that also has a different fill and no stroke. Use the W keyboard shortcut to select the Blend tool, or select it from the tool menu on the side. Click one shape, and then the other shape to create the blend. You have many blend options, including smooth color, specified steps, or specified distance. Each of them has advantages and disadvantages. To have a smooth flow, use smooth color, or a high number of specified steps, or a short specified distance. You can individually move the two shapes. You can also add additional anchor points along the path to create dynamic blended shapes. Use the Pen tool to add anchor points, and the Direct Selection tool to move them around. While the Blend tool is selected, hold the Option key and click on the blend to bring up the blend options. For the next blend, select the Ellipse tool and draw a circle that has a gradient. Select the circle and hold the Option key to drag and duplicate it. With the Blend tool selected, click one circle, then the next circle to create the blend. I have prepared some text paths. One has the letters separated as separate paths, and the other has all of the letters as one path to show you the difference. Click the blend and hold the Option key to drag and duplicate it. Then press Command D to continue to make copies. Select one of the blends, hold the Shift key, and select one of the paths. Then go to the top menu under Object, Blend, and select Replace Spline. Repeat this for the other paths and blend. There are additional options here, such as reverse front to back and reverse spine. These can be helpful to make the blend go in the direction that you want. Try it with your own blend and text. You can also blend multiple shapes together. Simply draw a number of shapes on the screen, then select the Blend tool and click on one shape after another, and it will create a blend. You can then reposition and modify the shapes to refine your blend. Now select a new shape that has no fill and a stroke of 1 point. Draw different shapes of different sizes on top of each other. These can be circles, squares, or triangles. Have some variety. Then select all the shapes and make a compound path. You can use the Shape Builder tool to eliminate any paths on the inside. Then click and drag holding the Option key to duplicate the path. You can move and rotate it and rescale it as you wish. With the Blend tool, click on one, then the other. Now you can modify the paths. You can also modify the stroke color so there is a blend in between them. Continue to change the scale, add anchor points, and modify until you are happy with the blend you created. You can also change the options of the blend. Blends can also be made with non-closed paths. Use the Pen tool to draw two different yet interesting paths. Move them apart, and then use the Blend tool to click one, then the other, to create a blend. This works best when you use different colors at both ends. You can modify it just like any other blend. Using two simple circles, a gradient, and multiple anchor points, with one circle being much larger than the other, can create the illusion of depth in a blend. You can also create a blend with multiple paths and then combine them in a compound path. You can then replace the path. Sometimes it is easier to see the spine of the blend by using Illustrator's outline mode. Press Command Y to get to the outline mode. Then, using the Pen tool, while you hold the Option key, you can click and drag to alter the anchor points and modify your blend. With this technique, you can make many different vectors for your projects.